A warm welcome to Professor Savant too. Mr. Savant, are you there?
Yeah, good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, ma'am. Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can very much hear you. It's very clear. We will wait for maybe 2 to 3 minutes and have some more people joining in, and then we shall resume the webinar.
Sure, ma'am. Sure.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Professor Savant, are you there right now? We can go ahead.
Yes, I'm there, ma'am.
Yeah, okay, that's nice. So very warm welcome to all the participants. Once again, CMDC is here with a yet another interesting topic and a very informative topic in the today's era. Speaking about today's era is the post-pandemic thing, wherein everybody is speaking about the new normal and how to make your businesses more strong, more strengthened, and this is only possible with the new era norm, which is the digitalizations. So once again, welcome to all the participants for this webinar on the emerging advanced digital skill technology adoption for basically speaking about RCF businesses, and this is about the digital learning initiative. When we speak about today's transformation because of the pandemic, we feel that somewhere the business has to be transformed. So there are a lot of organizations across the worldwide wherein they are coming up with strengthening their practices and systems. And this is not only getting the new processes, but also in upskilling the employees. And how do they upskill the employees is providing the training about the new digitalization, and that is a new normal. So it speaks about artificial intelligence, machine learning, Industry 4.0, Internet of Theory, and Industrial Internet of Things. So there's a huge gamut of digitalization, which we as employees of RCF actually need to get an overview and should look forward for having such practices or implementing of such practices in the in our systems. So today's webinar is basically to provide an overview about how this digitalization helps in enhancing our businesses and what changes or what transformations we could get into our businesses, how we could upskill our employees. Just giving a small example about artificial intelligence is, suppose if any employer, if any person wants to get some money out of us, has to do a payment of the credit card. So it is the artificial intelligence which helps in identifying which the person is and doing the verifications. So this actually helps into ensuring that the transaction is really smooth. So we have a very eminent faculty today with us to help us understand this new technology or this new digitalization, which is the new normal. And speaking about the faculty, we have with us Professor D.S. Savant, sir. He is an assistant professor. Mr. Savant, welcome to this webinar and welcome to RCF. He's an assistant professor with MPSTME, NIMIMS University. He has a 13 years of experience, area of specialization on Internet of Things, embedded control systems, robotics, and automation. He's also the secretary of the Smart Manufacturing and IIoT Division, ISA, US, which is at USA. He's a past president of the International Society of Automation, Maharashtra, for the year 1920. He's a student section liaison of the International Society of Automation District 14 Asia Pacific Committee. He's into a lot of activities and is a member of IETE. Professor Savant, you will have to tell us the full form of a lot of nomenclatures which has been used over here. He has been awarded as the best faculty for the year 2019 by NMIMS University. He's a recourse person for IIoT, embedded systems, robotics, industrial automations, control system, MATLAB, NSC3, LaTeX, etc. He's presented 8 papers in the national and international conferences, published 3 journal papers, book reviewer for Tata McGraw-Hill, Oxford University, Cambridge University. He's also a recipient of numerous awards. To speak about few of them are the Yuva Gaurav Award 2015 from Mumbai Mayor at Mumbai, the Best Performer Award 2015 from IST Delhi at Raipur, the ISA Student Mentor of the Year 2016 from USA, California, the ISA Volunteer Leader for the Year 2018, again from Canada, Best Faculty Award from NMIMS University, and the Confederation of Allied Academicians of Indian Innovation Challenge Design Contest by Department of Science and Technology and Texas Instruments. He's an ISSA Section Leader of the Year 2020 from ISA USA. So he has got a lot of credentials to his account, and we are very fortunate, Professor Sawant, to have you accepted our request to facilitate our employees on this new technology, on the digital skills, and we eagerly await for your contribution to this webinar. Thank you, and welcome once again to RCA.
Thank you, ma'am, introducing me. It was really nice start, I can say. And before going with my session, I would like to again thankful to all my RCF family members for inviting me for this today's webinar. I would like to mention also Mr. Sharad Sonawane sir, who was constantly, you know, interacting me for arranging this seminar. And I should not, you know, forget the name of Mr. H.K. Kadam sir. He was also involved in this because he was part of the RCF earlier days. So I would like to thank everyone, also ma'am, for nice introduction of my side. So if you permit me,
surely.
Can I share my screen?
Yeah.
So
Larissa,
I'm giving him the rights, so you need to stop sharing.
I'm stopping my screen. Can you just make him the host, please?
Yes, I've made him the host already.
Yeah. Thank you. Ma'am, screen is visible?
Yeah, it is visible.
Yeah, thank you. So just now ma'am was saying what was the full form. The IEI's Institute of Engineers of India, SMISA, Senior Member of International Society Automation, ISA. IES, again, a member of Institute of Engineers of India. IST is what? That is Indian Society of Technical Education. IET is what again? Institution of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineer. IEEE, everyone knows. So IEEE and ISA both are the standard making technical society. And this is my short profile currently, I believe. And recently I had elected as a secretary of the ISA Smart Manufacturing Industrial IoT Division USA. So today's topic is Emerging Advanced Digital Skill Technology Adoption for RCF Business under this digital learning initiative. There are five different topics were given, starting with AI and machine learning. Then is a big data, cloud technology, IoT. So as suggested by Mr. Sharad sir, it's different possible presentation. So we'll take over to you on each topic, and at the end, I have taken care that I will relate all this technology with the chemical industries where RCF families actually belongs. And ultimately, I will give the idea how this digitization works at an industry level. Now you will say, what is this? I request all participating, just observe what exactly it is. I believe this picture is quite visible to everyone. Just give me 1 minute, sorry. Yeah. Just go for 1 minute, observe different things in that picture. You will understand something. Okay, I think I have given 1 minute of time to analyze, and now I will talk on this picture specifically. People have been trying to make a machine that behaves like humans for a long time. Back in 1770, a Hungarian inventor created a machine that made wood play chess against human opponents. The machine had a human-sized model of person. That is a machine. The machine had a human-sized model of person dressed in a Turkish robes that would move a piece on a board. It was great illusion, but everything was done by person sitting inside the machine. This is where we get the term mechanical term. Something that seems automated, but actually has manual labor behind the scene. About 230 years later, the artificial intelligence was able to do so for real. When Gary was beaten by Deep Blue in match play in 1997. So I believe this is the introduction of artificial intelligence, exactly why artificial intelligence started. So you can observe very specifically, what is artificial intelligence? In a simple manner, you can observe on the left side, there's a what? Input. Right side is an output. And there's a black box. That black box is AI. But what is that exactly? In general, we can say that we can define it is ability for a machine to perform tasks that would normally require a person to do. And just like people, it is the ability to take the information, make decision based on it, and cause an action to be taken, such as moving an arm, creating an image or text, or providing intelligent suggestion. I believe all my RCF family members, they know some of the technologies very well. But still, we'll also see I was doing that screen skating. Sorry for that. So now going for the, what are different types of artificial intelligence? So you can observe basically when researchers talk about AI, there may be different types of intelligence. They could be referring to, one is called artificial super intelligence. It is a kind of thing that we see in a sci-fi and would end up being a godlike intellectual. It is something that would, for outspace human capabilities in the same outpace insects, but it is a very hypothetical for now. Bearing things closer to the reality is the story of artificial general intelligence. The key here is that it is a general purpose machine that can apply skill to any problem. In a similar way, as a person could be a trained to do most things, they are not built for specific tasks. This is the goal for research at the moment, and we may be slowly moving closer. But let's bring things down to the type of artificial intelligence you may already see in the world. Are all examples of artificial neurointelligence. That is, it's machine that is designed to be good at one specific task. It may be complex, like driving a car, or fairly simple, like identifying spam emails, but it is still quite a narrow skill set. So this is something about the different types and where we are today, that also I explained by this slide. Then we'll go for the what are the different subsets of artificial intelligence. You can observe very carefully. The subsets are machine learning and deep learning. Many people say ML is AI, AI is ML, deep learning is machine learning. Yeah. But what exactly? What is in depth that we'll understand by this slide? There are many tools and approaches that have been developed to help us closer to the goal of artificial intelligence. But some of them have been getting much more attention recently. A couple of terms you need to hear in a combination with artificial intelligence these days in machine learning and deep learning. And these are the methods and tools used in developing application of artificial intelligence. So exactly, let's look at them a bit more in depth. What is this machine learning? First of all, we have machine learning. So for our artificially intelligent machine to know how to behave, it has to be taught what to do. In the past, this was done by programming individual skills manually. But as you can guess, this was quite a labor and skill intensive process. Over time, researchers developed methods to allow machines to learn by themselves. There are various approaches, but in general, they have same thing in common. Initially, a machine learning algorithm. What is machine learning algorithm? A program that allows machine to learn. So initially, machine learning algorithm is provided with large amount of data that allows to develop rule based on data it sees. Sorry. These rules are tested, and once the developers are happy that algorithm is providing the appropriate responses, it is released on the next stage. So you can observe the data, there are training, the predictions are happening, And then after the train model is put into production, where it is provided with the input and it provides output that are used in other places in the system. For all this, we need a data. The type of data available may inform what method we are able to use for this training. So this is the typical block diagram presentation of machine learning. So there are different approaches of machine learning. Supervised learning, unsupervised learning, reinforcement learning. The most traditional would use large set of well-labeled data. So for example, if you are training AI to detect spam emails, you would provide it with lots of emails where the spam messages have been identified. The model will then able to learn the unique features and they make an email to be more likely to be spam. If labeled data set is not available, it is possible to look at the pattern within a large amount of information. And basically, this could help combine set of customers into similar groups. Means where we are doing the clustering. So just now I gave the email spam exam that is called supervised learning. But where data is not available, labeled data set is not available, where you can use the unsupervised learning. And that is called cluster similar documents based on the text content. And the last approach is to give model some success criteria, like navigating an obstacle course or winning a game, or let it figure out the best way to do that by either winning or losing after each attempt. So, but how do these model actually train themselves to this classification or identification? And that's where the deep learning comes in. So when again you have to do it very depth level. So after that, what exactly the deep learning role starts? So what is deep learning basically? It's a part of machine learning, just now I mentioned, of learning representation of data. It utilizes learning algorithm that derive meaning of day by using hierarchy of multiple layers that mimic neural network of our brain. And if you provide the system with lots of information, so it analyze it, it understand, and it respond in a useful ways. So this is when I show that black box is what AI, right side is output and the left side is input. So these are different applications which are available with the help of this machine learning concept. So input is what picture and response are the human faces. This is a 0 or 1, an application you can do the photo tagging. Recently, there's a concept called self-driving car is really emerging topic at India level as well. Foreign, they have worked really nice level. So here again, for self-driving car, the position of other car is very important. And that is learned. And with respect to learning mechanism, we can get the desirable output. So that is the self-driving car is also the application of the machine learning. Just many of the RCF scientists, engineers, probably if they want to work some of the AI and ML project. So basically, these are the, some of the keys which I have highlighted. First of all, clear first business needs at the plant level, at the industry level. Define specific project or product. For machine learning or for AI, the data plays very important role. So you have to find the data.
Professor Savan, there was just a request by participants. If you can, when you're explaining, if you can use a little bit of Hindi.
Okay.
When you have to use a technical term, it's fine.
Actually, I require your permission because sometimes what happens, speakers speak in a Hindi and then that should not be wrong impression, interpretation.
Please use a little bit of Hindi, sir.
It's my pleasure. I will do that. I will try.
Thanks.
Yeah. So, यहाँ पे data बहुत ही important role play करता है when we would like to develop the artificial intelligence and machine learning project. Then build or find a tool or model, whether आपके engineers वो tool create कर सकते हैं, और there are commercial licenses are available, so हम buy भी कर सकते हैं. And the last, the test and adjustment. Use your interaction to keep improving that algorithm. So these are the various keys to successful AI and ML project. So just now we completed what is the machine learning, what is AI, what is deep learning. I started with one picture. मैंने आपको एक picture दिखाया and exactly what was that picture. मैंने पूरा story बताया and then how AI started. After AI, what is machine learning? What is deep learning? That also we understood. Now we go to the next topic called big data. The word is big. But what is this big data? I really appreciate RCF family. They have selected, I will say, technical language mein usko bolte hai. The correlation words. तो आज के वेबिनार के जो keywords लिए हैं आपने, वो बहुत ही correlated है. And that is the, I feel very, you know, interestful for this today's webinar. Like AI, big data, how this big data going on cloud. Now ये उसके बाद IoT का इसे major play role करता है. And many times people are confused what is IoT and what is IIoT. Okay. And there's a word called digitization. So all these I have covered in my slide, already have covered just now the machine learning. So this is something called big data everywhere. Just now, when madam was introducing me, she gave one example of same ATM wala example. And same it is highlighted here. So big data is everywhere. Lots of data is being collected and warehoused. See, मैंने अभी भी बताया कि these words are correlated. ये words क्यों correlated है? Because to apply good machine learning algorithm, you require data, and that should be also quality data. So lots of data that you have to collect it, and that is data can be the web data, e-commerce data, purchase at a department, bank and credit card transaction, or social network. That is with respect to application level. As at your RCF level, the data will be different. The temperature, or come the pressure level, or the pH level. So this will be your data for, you know, to analyze specific chemical reaction or specific running of plant. This is one, the Earthscope. Earthscope is the world largest science project designed to track North America's geological evolution. And this observatory recorded data over 3.8 million square miles, massing 67 terabytes of data. So this is one of the good example. You can Google it afterwards. You can get a lot of good information on this, on Earth scope. Data कौन से types के होते हैं? That is also very important. When we are talking about the big data, but what are different types of data? The one data is, the types of data is called as relation data. You can make in a tables, transaction, legacy data. One is called text data, web-based. Semi-structured data, XML. Then graphical data. That is also one of the data. And graphical data you can take from social network, semantic web. And the streaming data, where I mentioned very clearly, you can only scan the data once. So there are different types of data. See, the time is limited, so I won't go in a statistic. That is also really one very interesting topic. But I'm giving some of the keywords. What to do with this data? Now we got the data. बहुत लोग बोलते हैं AI अप्लाई करो, मशीन लर्निंग अप्लाई करो, बट क्या करो एक्सैक्टली? सो ऑन दिस डेटा वी आर डूइंग सम ऑफ द एग्रीगेशंस, और आई विल से सिंपली वी आर अप्लाइंग सम ऑफ द स्टैटिस्टिक कॉन्सेप्ट. देन देयर इज अ कॉन्सेप्ट कॉल्ड इंडेक्सिंग, सर्चिंग एंड क्वेरी. दिस just remember this word indexing, searching. This is very important role in data, in AI, in IoT. Very, very simple example. In your chemical industries, if you're taking the data from specific sensor, so for that sensor, we have to do some of the indexing. And because there are many sensors are installed in the plant, so every sensor will be having some of the unique number, and by that indexing we can search that specific sensor, and from that specific sensor only we can extract the data. So just imagine at a one point, if we are to do complete plant on a digitization level, and it should be work independently. Agar aisa karna hai, तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वो डेटा एक्यूरेटली सर्वर पे आना चाहिए. ऑन सर्वर योर ऑल इंजीनियर्स विल बी डूइंग सम गुड एल्गोरिथम विच विल रन द प्लांट वेरी यू नो इन अ सक्सेसफुल लाइन ऑफ एक्शन. एंड इफ एनी प्रॉब्लम इज देयर, सो यूर आपने जो एआई एल्गोरिथम डेवलप किया है बाय डेटा एनालिटिक्स, they give the solution in a shorter time. So that's why I'm saying again and again ki ye sab word ek dusre ke sath bahut hi closely correlated hai. On the same knowledge discovery, there's a data mining and statistical modeling. We'll see that. I have given some of the idea for this also. So what is this OLAP and data mining? This is typical warehouse architecture. So there's a metadata, is you can say it is coming from all the sources, all different types of sources. The data is coming at one point, and client with respect to its query, we have to provide the solution, and we have to analyze the data and provide the solution. This is a one warehouse architecture. What is ROLAP, or I will say ROLAP versus MOLAP? What is this OLAP? First understand, that is called online analytical processing. So ROLAP is relational online analytical processing, and MOLAP is what? Multidimensional online analytical processing. So there are two types of analytical processing you can do with respect to data. And this is online is happening, that you understand very carefully. So that type of machine learning algorithm aapko develop karna hoga. Now what is data mining exactly? Data mining kya hai? When you will be having the huge data, lots of data is coming. So what is called data mining? Discovery of useful and possibly unexpected patterns in a data. हमें से उसमें यूजफुल डेटा ही निकालना है. फिर अगेन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक. जब हम बोलते हैं ना कि कोई भी चीज को यूजफुल निकालना है, एक पानी, हमें बहुत अच्छा पानी चाहिए, क्लीन एंड क्रिस्टल क्लियर वाटर, फॉर हर हेल्थ के लिए भी अच्छा होता है, तो हम क्या लगाते हैं, घर पे फिल्टर लगाते हैं. सो सेम यर डेटा ऑल्सो, टू गेट अ यूजफुल डेटा वी हैव टू डू सम ऑफ द apply the algorithms, do the some of the filtering. We'll see that also in a subsequent slides as well. So non-trivial extraction of implicit, previously unknown and potentially useful information from the data. Exploration and analysis by automatic or semi-automatic of large quantities of data in order to discover meaning of full patterns. Just now we अभी हमने बात किया यूजफुल डेटा, और यूजफुल डेटा ऐसा डायरेक्टली नहीं मिलेगा कि इतना रॉ डेटा आ रहा है और डायरेक्टली गेटिंग कंप्लीट रॉ डेटा यू विल से इट इज अ यूजफुल डेटा. नो, आई वोंट से दैट. सो बेसिकली यू हैव टू एक्सट्रैक्ट एग्जैक्ट डेटा विच यू आर इंटरेस्टेड. सो बेसिकली इन दैट वी कैन से different data mining tasks. The first is classification, then we have to do the clustering means group, then we have to apply some of the association rule, then sequential pattern discovery, regression, predictiveness, deviation detection, that is also predictive, and collaborative filter. So with the help of we can do the data mining. I won't go in a depth. Probably when I will share my slide to Mr. Sharad sir, probably you can read from this all these relevant words from this slide. So basically, first step is classification. So classification, a given a collection of record training set, and each record contains set of attributes, and one of the attribute is called class. So this is called one decision trees. I have given example. So one example, conducted survey to see what customer were interested in new model car. So you can observe there is a yes response from C1 to C4 customer, and no from C5 and C6. So with respect to this training set, we can come to the one some of the decision. This is again clustering. We are doing clustering with respect to same group of data. जैसे हम age wise का एक cluster करेंगे, that is called clustering. फिर with respect to education लोगों का एक cluster करेंगे, income wise. So these are the different permutation combination. With respect to that, उस data में you can do the clustering. See, this is age, this is education wise, and again we have to do some of the association rules. Ki hum aapne jaise is picture mein aap bahut hi acche se dekh rahe ho ki humne p2 p5 aur p8 ye customer ko ye products ko ek sath laya hai. Okay, तो आप अच्छे से देखोगे वो टेबल में कि P2 P5 को P5 और P8 को मैक्सिमम टाइम लाया है. क्यों लाया है? बिकॉज ट्रेंड ऐसा चल रहा था, प्रोडक्ट P5 एंड P8 ऑफन बॉट टुगेदर. ओके, एंड कस्टमर 12, सेकंड कंक्लूजन, कस्टमर 12 लाइक्स प्रोडक्ट P9. सो देयर आर डिफरेंट रूल्स that we are bringing some of the set of parameters together. Then this is one more example, association rule discovery. One maine ek potato chips ka ek example diya hai, I think that you can read afterwards as well. Now this is very important, collaborative filtering. So predict what movies, books person may be interested on the basis of past preference. Then one approach based on the repeated clustering. And above problem is an instance of collaborative filtering where users collaborate in the task of filtering information to find information of interest. That is called data mining. Because lot of data, bahut sara data aa gaya hai, but usme se aapko useful data hi aapko bahar nikalna hai. Aur uske upar aapko analysis karna hai. There are different types of mining, text mining and the graphical mining as well. Data stream भी होते हैं. There are continuous data stream. Why this data stream? Because the arriving speed of stream and the huge amount of data are beyond our capability to store them. Okay. Now data अभी आ चुका है, but where to store? That is again important factor, and that's why मेरा ये slide हमारे next topic का correlation है. मैं फिर से बताता हूँ. अभी डेटा एक्सट्रैक्ट तो कर लिया हमने, डेटा पे हमने अलग अलग एसोसिएशन रूल अप्लाई कर दिए, फिल्टरिंग अप्लाई कर दिया, प्रेडिक्टिवनेस के लिए अलग अलग रिग्रेशन एल्गोरिथम अप्लाई कर दिए. अभी डेटा तो कलेक्ट हो गया है, बट जस्ट इमेजिन प्लांट में से डेली डेटा आ रहा है. सो वी कैन नॉट स्टोर एट द हार्ड. यस वी कैन स्टोर सम ऑफ द डेटा ऑन हार्ड डिस्क, बट विच इज नॉट पॉसिबल. इतने बड़े प्लांट में इतने सेंसर होंगे केमिकल इंडस्ट्रीज में, हर एक सेंसर से अलग अलग टाइप का डेटा आ रहा होगा और उसको रियल टाइम पे आपको स्टोर करना है. सो व्हाट इज द नीड, दैट इज कॉल्ड नेक्स्ट इज कॉल्ड द क्लाउड. वी रिक्वायर द क्लाउड, द गुड क्लाउड वेयर वी कैन स्टोर दिस डेटा. सो बेसिकली एंड आई वोंट टेक जस्ट ओनली क्लाउड, आई विल टेक द क्लाउड कंप्यूटिंग ऑल्सो. So that we will explain because that is very important. So cloud computing is a general term used to describe a new class of network based computing that takes place over the internet. So basically a step on from utility computing, a collection integrated network hardware, software, internet infrastructure called platform. Using the internet for communication, transport, provides hardware, software and networking services to clients. So there is a one term called API. It is called API ko hum bolte hai, application programming interface. So these platforms hide the complexity detail of underlying infrastructure from users application by providing very simple graphical interface, or we say API. In addition, the platform provides the demand services that are always anywhere, anytime and any place. See mere webinar mein fir se ek baar wahi cheez bata raha hu ki ye jo sab word, mai again I appreciate Sharad sir and HK Kadam sir ki inhone jo wo word jo design kiya, aur 100% I won't say ki ye log ne, aap sabhi log ne unko input diya hoga, aur ye hamare webinar ke jo terms hai wo itne correlated है. अभी that are always anywhere, anytime, any place. When I'm saying anywhere, anytime, any place, मेरा topic चल रहा है cloud, but automatically मुझे एक flavor आ गया IoT का. Okay, IoT is the same. Okay, so this is ये थोड़े से अलग है, but they are very correlated. Data आ गया तो save करना है, save किया तो analytics करना है, analytics करना है तो उसका फिर से close loop में हमें कुछ तो responsive action लेना है. Okay. So this is something about a cloud. I remotely hosted clouds are available. Then the commodify, the result utility committee computing model similar to traditional, that of traditional utilities like gas and electricity. Okay, so these are different characteristics that define cloud data and where application services and infrastructures are there. So this is one cloud architecture. We'll see in a short. So cloud comp, this typical architecture, if you observe, there are service value nets. Then I will say this is called PaaS. That is called PaaS. The full form is what? Platform as a service. And these are called IaaS. That is called infrastructure as a service. What is this? We'll see here. Cloud computing is a model for enabling convenient on-demand network access to share pool of configurable computing resources, like example network, servers, storage, application and services. And that can be rapidly provisioned, released with the minimal management efforts and or service provider interaction. Cloud computing customers do not own their physical infrastructure, which is very important. Just now I mentioned that. Cloud computing users avoid capital expenditure on hardware, software and services when they pay a provider only for what they use. So basically, low share infrastructure and cost, low management overhead, and immediate access to the broad range of application. That is look for the basically the cloud computing. These are the different cloud computing characteristics. Words are some of the familiar to you also, but I will give some of the small introduction of some of the words called scalability. There's a word called scalability. When we say infrastructure capacity allows traffic pricing or minimizes delays. Then resilient computing means cloud provides a mirror solution to minimize downtime in the event of disaster. The type of resiliency can give the business sustainability they need during the unanticipated events. Homogeneity, everyone knows. On-demand self-service, broad network access, resource pooling. Then resource pooling, I will say here, that is called also, I will say in a different language called multi-tenant model. There's a sense of location independence in the customer generally has no control or knowledge over the exact location of the provide resources, but may be able to specific location at a high level of abstraction. Then some of the essential characteristic called, just now I say resource pooling, then others are what? Rapid elasticity and major services. I will share all this slide to you. So, aaj ka ye webinar RCF family members ke liye दिया गया था, बेसिकली ऑर्गेनाइज किया गया था है उसके लिए. इन अ सिंपल लैंग्वेज आई विल से, एज आई एम फ्रॉम फैकल्टी बैकग्राउंड और वी यूजुअली वी वर्क ऑन अ रिसर्चर लेवल, तो मुझे आप सबको एक एडवाइस करना है कि ये टॉपिक बहुत ह्यूज है. सो यहाँ पे आई सजेस्ट कि आज का आज को जो अभी वेबिनार्स के जो कीवर्ड्स है, एआई, क्लाउड कंप्यूटिंग, आईओटी, बिग डेटा, ये आपके एक बहुत बड़े बड़े रिसर्च टॉपिक है. अक्रॉस द ग्लोब बहुत बड़ा रिसर्च चल रहा है. सो आई बिलीव कि आरसीएफ में जो फ्रेश इंजीनियर्स रहेंगे, डिप्लोमा होल्डर्स रहेंगे, उनका तो ये स्टार्टिंग एज ऑफ द करियर है. और इफ वी देख, अगर वो इसमें से कोई भी एक टॉपिक अपना एक सेल्फ इंटरेस्ट टॉपिक लेंगे, तो बहुत आगे आने वाले दिनों में दे कैन डू रियली नाइस टेक्निकल एक्टिविटी एट आरसीएफ. दे कैन डेवलप गुड एआईएमएल प्रोजेक्ट एंड दे कैन डू गुड रिसर्च एट द आरसीएफ. सो दीज आर द different models. On the left side, I have given the some of the example where we are working on different platform. One platform called SaaS, That is software as a service. Second is what? Platform as a service. So CRM and the Lotus LiveView are the typical example. The PaaS or Google application or Windows Azure. And the one is called infrastructure as a service. That is called IaaS, where the typical example are the, we know that is called Amazon Web Services and the Rackspace hosting. So these are different models, basically. So this is the typical SaaS maturity model. There are four levels. The first level, there is a one instance per customer. Second level, there is a what configuration. Third, again, configuration, multi-tenant efficiency. That is called characteristic of cloud. And the fourth level is scalable, configurable, multi-tenant efficiency. So these are the different, again, different cloud computing layers, application service, application platform, server platform, and storage platform. And with respect to this, there are different current service provider, or I can say not only service provider, I will say they have utilizing this cloud computing concept in their business. So cloud computing services level, again, same services, application, development, platform, storage, and last is what? Hosting. And it always application focus and the infrastructure focus. I won't go more into this characteristic because these are the many different characteristics I have given in the my PPTs. So when you refer, you go, I will share this PPT to Sharad sir. When you take a typical research area cloud, that time you can talk. So these are the some commercial cloud offerings are also available. Amazon, GoGrid, 3Tera, Mosso, Joint, Verio. There are the same, the typical example, Amazon Simple Services. There are some of the features also I have mentioned here. EC2 is also one of the thing. And I have given some of the opportunities and challenges in cloud computing. I think just now maine jo abhi bataya ki jo fresh engineers hai, diploma holders hai, they can please read these opportunities and challenges. I think you get a good research area to do some of the good project at the RCL. I won't talk more on this because I'm going further because some of the features scope also have mentioned. Now this is which I would like to highlight. The correlate all my different different topics together and with respect to chemical industry because RCF, when we are saying the RCF, I look as a chemical prospect only. And this is very much interesting of today's webinar, which I would like to talk with you called IoT. This time also limited, that's why I'm going ahead. So what is IoT insight into industry trends? So this is a typical picture. There are different boilers are there and the plant is continuously on 365 days, sometimes shutdown is there. So we'll see this IoT and IoT with respect to basically industry point of view. So what is IoT and IoT? The Internet of Things or IoT is a system of interrelated computing devices, mechanical and digital machines, objects, animals, people that are provided with unique identifier. See, agar aapne mera session pura suna hoga, to maine ek bola tha, that is called indexing or searching. Okay. So every device having unique identifier. So with respect to this UID is basically the ability to transfer the data over network without require human to human or human to computer interaction. So what is thing? Thing in the Internet of the Thing can be any natural or man-made object that can be assigned an IP address and is able to transfer data over a network. Typical example, a person with a heart monitor implant. See, this is one good example. this COVID-19 also, many of the researchers are developing different projects, as we everyone know that pura world aaj COVID se suffer ho raha hai. So SpO2 level ke liye lot of people are doing different projects. This is one, just now I mentioned what these are called, animals. So how this animal world is correlated with IoT? A farm animal with a biochip transponder. So this is one good example. And automobile that has built-in sensor to alert the driver when tire pressure is low. So we are real-time traffic, we can say. Everything is real-time you're getting. Sensor alert. So what is basically the IoT and IoT? In an instrumentation language, I will talk very nice manner. Internet of Things is also natural extension of SCADA. Sabko SCADA pata hi hoga, because RCF, PLC SCADA. So Internet of Things is also natural extension of SCADA, supervisory control data acquisition, a category of software application program for process control, process industry. The gathering of data in a real time from remote location to the control equipment and condition. Yes, just now I am saying that chemical industry mein hazardous is a very important issue, and go with manual observation not possible. So in that process industry, we are implanting, installing different sensor, and with respect to sensor, we are bringing the data at one of the location. And from that, we are extracting the data, real-time data. So the hardware gathers and feeds the data into computer that has SCADA software installed, where it is then processed and presented in a timely manner, which is very important. Timely manner is very important, because data should be, you know, real-time. There should not be delay. Then only we can take some of the precaution measure hum le sakte hain. So in a simple language, the last generation of SCADA, I will say first generation of IoT. This is typical SCADA platform. Many of the, you know, also you have work. This is your regular activity, probably some of the members. And this is, you can say, just now the all the words just now I said are together. Cloud, I said, so we are putting the data on a cloud, end nodes, assets. Then from sensor, we are taking the data to connect the or to exchange the data from sensor to cloud. We require the gateways or edges. Okay, so this is one network. We'll see that. So these are the different IoT applications. IoT smart buildings called security, lighting, HVAC. Fire safety, 24/7 monitoring, energy management. So this is the one good application when industry can focus. Smart city component. This is also one of the good, like smart city means smart manufacturing, smart government, mobility, smart digital citizens, open data, smart health, smart farming, smart buildings, smart grid, smart transportation. And again, same. This is complete, but when this smart will happen, basically you require the sensors hub. There are number of sensors should be connected at a different location, and from the this you can observe this system over you, like vision based patient monitoring, respiratory tube checking, fluid monitoring, space occupancy, bed, with the help of sensor hubs, with the WAN and LAN, with the TCP/IP protocol, we are collecting the data over the Wi-Fi or GSM, and we are doing the analysis, and we are sending the this data on a cloud, and the useful data, that useful data is very important, and that's why we all are together. Hum sab aaj iske liye kaam kar rahe, Digital India, power to empower, and I really appreciate and thankful to the RCF ki wahi prospects jo hamare पीएम नरेंद्र मोदी जी सर ने जो एक विजन लाया है डिजिटल इंडिया, उस प्रोविजन से आपने जो आज वेबिनार रखा, रियली नाइस activity which you plan at RCF level. Coming back to IoT, so what is this IoT? जैसे मैंने machine AI के time में आपको एक picture दिखाया और बताया कि कैसे AI start हुआ, वैसे IoT का भी एक history है. Kevin is a co-founder of the Auto ID Center at MIT. First mentioned the Internet of Things in a presentation he made Procter and Gamble in 1999. उन्होंने उस प्रेजेंटेशन में क्या दिखाया, वांटिंग टू ब्रिंग रेडियो फ्रीक्वेंसी आईडी आरएफआईडी टू द अटेंशन ऑफ पीएनजी सीनियर मैनेजमेंट, एस्टन कॉल्ड हिज प्रेजेंटेशन इंटरनेट ऑफ थिंग्स टू इनकॉर्पोरेट द कूल न्यू ट्रेन ऑफ 1919 द इंटरनेट, एंड एमआईटी प्रोफेसर नेल बुक व्हेन थिंग्स स्टार्ट टू थिंक, रियली नाइस सेंटेंस, व्हेन थिंग्स स्टार्ट टू थिंक also appearing in 1919, did not use the exact terms but provided clear vision of where IoT was headed. So where exactly this IoT started in that presentation when he brought RFID to the attention to all their senior management of PNG, and that time that Internet of Thing terms came. So, मैं हर जगह पे अभी यही सुनता हूँ, इंडस्ट्री 4.0, इंडस्ट्री 4.0. व्हाट इज दिस इंडस्ट्री 4.0? सो इंडस्ट्री 4.0 जो फर्स्ट रिवोल्यूशन हुआ, दैट इज कॉल्ड मैकेनाइजेशन, स्टीम पावर, वेविंग लूम इन 1784, दैट इज कॉल्ड इंडस्ट्री 1.0. सेकेंड रिवोल्यूशन में क्या हुआ, 1870s में, जहां पे मास प्रोडक्शन असेंबली लाइन आई, इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी कॉन्सेप्ट आया. 1969 जिसमें ऑटोमेशन वर्ड आया, कंप्यूटर एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स, थर्ड रिवोल्यूशन, एंड नाउ वी आर सेइंग द फोर्थ रिवोल्यूशन, इंडस्ट्री 4.0. द मेजर कीवर्ड्स आर टुडे आर द साइबर फिजिकल सिस्टम, इंटरनेट ऑफ थिंग्स, नेटवर्क्स, द मशीन लर्निंग, द क्लाउड, ऑल दिस आर टर्म रिलेटेड आई विल से द इंडस्ट्री 4.0. So typical, these are the our instrumentations, analog input, analog output, then the DIDO, some of the wireless gateways. There's a controller to handle all this, and there's a what, SCADA operator console. Then the server is also there, and with respect to server, the cloud, we can the data to the cloud, and at a process industry layer, there are different layers like machine manager, reliability manager, HSSE, like health, security, safety, environmental, and the process engineer. So they all work together, and the data which we are storing in the cloud with respect to, you know, we can do some of the analytics and we can develop some of the good algorithms, run the plant in a different manner, and that is called industrial internet of things. So connected services are based on see, decide and act. So again, same, which are today's all correlated word. One, we require data collection, on-premise sensing and data collection is required, see. Then analytics and action. We have to act, repair, recommendation, collaboration or services. We have to do analytics on action on that. And for that, we have to require the data monitoring, or we require the experts to decide. So see, decide, act. As the connected services are based on see, decide and act. So this is one example I have taken from this. You can observe that is... application for safety data display from remote area 1.5 kilometer. There's a what, CO and ethylene gas storage, 4 to 20 milliamp analog signal to wireless transmission. Then entire wireless infrastructure network is implemented there. And then wireless gateways, antenna for signal transfer, wireless gateways. at a DCS graphics, we can get the real-time monitoring. There's also one, this is chiller condition monitoring IoT implementation. Same, the data is collected through the PLC controller. There's a SCADA or the HMI. Again, there's a what real-time data analytics is done with the data extracted to the gateways and which is stored on the cloud. And at a process engineer, they can see the real-time monitoring anytime, anywhere, and anything. So the process engineer on their HMI or their on their mobile, they can observe the complete monitoring of the plant. These are the specific, I believe, the challenges and opportunities in mobility, IT infrastructure and network security in chemical process industries. I have noted some of things. I believe you all are the experts in chemical industry. Probably you can also give some of the highlights on this after the session. But possibly I have highlighted some of the things like maintenance challenges, the pump failures lead server downtime. The maintenance team gets to know only after the occurrence of the failure. Condition monitoring lets maintenance team get notified situation prior to failure. And all kind of mechanical equipment can be monitored. Uptime of assets can be increased. And this is possible with the help of if you go for then infrastructure challenges are there. Like just now you have said is an outdated system. That obsolete system DLC and PLC have to upgrade it as when and necessary in order to prevent a loss of data. Because existing system is not compatible for digital transformation. When we are saying digital transformation, we have to migrate to the new system. And network must be capable of transferring such as humanogenous data and secure enough to the cyber assault. Now, this is also one of the things which I will discuss. Mobility. Maintenance team uses FLP, Android, based smartphones and integrated HMI fetching data, SCADA, PLC, DCS, other system can be handled for the operator. See, there are advantages, but there are also disadvantages, or I will say there are some of the liabilities, I will say. So what are the IoT liabilities? We can say plant's control system can be exposed to the cyber attack. So possible threats for the IoT liability is what system malfunction, cyber assault, access to the control system, information theft. So security is prime in Internet of Things. So that is also one of the research area. So system malfunction, possible threat I have mentioned, like a deeper level of information, automation based on IoT system are done, for instance. Automatic ordering on inventory is based on IoT data on cloud. Then malfunction of instrument glitches in networking, programming may lead financial loss. Yes, sir, many times we see it. When a typical example, we Swiggy pe order dete, or sometimes due to some of the things, the error goes. And our money get deducted, but order is not placed. So prevention, a manual check has to be made mandatory in case of taking actions upon IoT data. Cyber is a one of the threat. The other application, the device in which IoT application is accessed might be prone to the cyber attack. So how to prevent, build in protection, then encryption, risk analysis, authorization, you can do two-level or three-level authorization. So with the help of, we can do better thing. Access to control system, that is also one liability possible threat. Intruder can gain access to process control network because everything on a network, if possibly he can take the access over the network. So intruder can alter the opening of critical walls that maybe leads to disaster, at least at chemical industry. So prevention, since the flow of data is unidirectional, only processed data are fetched from the control system to opaque OPC channel and the communication with cloud through remote system, this threat can be limited for our case. Information threat also, you can observe there is a big data and internet thing. So possible threat, since the data points are from critical processes, can expose the history of parameters, critical process to the competitors. Diligent work around the data combined with our purchase data. So prevention, again, same, we can say, building protection, encryption, decryption, risk analysis, authorization. Again, these are the prevention we can do. So I'm coming to my last two slides. It's accelerated digital transformation through connectivity and cognition, which is very important. So these are the different things when we are looking for the digitalization. One is called digitalization, where digitization in a massive scale through edge technologies, actuator, chips, cores, controller, LEDs, sensors, specs, stickers, tag, etc. Connectivity. Embedded systems are networked to communicate, collaborate, correlate, collaborate with the one another. Device to device, device to cloud integration towards the software-based application with maturity of the Internet of Things technology and cyber-physical system. Service enablement, service enabling the digitized and connected entities. Data validation, when billions of different distributed services interact, massive and multi-structured data get produced and has to be collected and cleansed. Context information has to be embedded with the digital data. That is, just now I say, called data mining. So, and the digital intelligence by cognition, applying big, fast, and streaming analytics on a digital data systematically is to create predictive, prescriptive. So the last line is the key line for today's webinar. Digitization, I will say IoT. Digital intelligence, I will say IoT, data analytics, machine learning paves the way for digitally empower and transform enterprises. This is a complete what we discussed in last, I believe, I don't know the time, but almost for last 90 minutes. And this is the last slide, how to make IoT environment intelligent. So for this, we require the Internet of Agents, for empowering each digital object to adaptive, articulate, reactive, cognitive through mapping on software agent. The concept of digital twin, this is also another research area. Other one, two-hour session, we can have digital twinning. The proven and potential IoT data analytics at edge and cloud levels is very important. The application of artificial intelligence technologies, machine learning, deep learning algorithms, computer vision, natural language processing, video processing, leads to realization of smarter system services and solution. The new concept, smart contracts being popularized through blockbuster blockchain. Blockchain technology, again, this is one of the research area, leads to sophisticated decentralized application. Thank you from my side. I think now we can discuss if anyone would like to discuss something. And this last thank you slide also you can say, does your car have any idea why my car pull it over? This is called IoT world, which we are looking after probably after 10 or 20 years. And where the husband and wife are discussing, we have to go out for a dinner. The refrigerator is not speaking to stove. So just now that author mentioned, when things start to things, that time I will say the Internet of Things. I believe IoT is already starting a really different revolution. And thank you for listening me patiently from last 90 minutes. I once again thank you to all RCF family to giving me opportunity to give some of the highlights on digital digitization, also this some of the skill technology, AI, cloud computing, big data, IoT. And there's a strong correlation which I mentioned. I would like to thank again Sharad sir, HKS Kadam sir, and also ma'am for introducing me. And once again, thanks a lot. Stay safe, take care. And then, yeah, some of the chat session I can observe, I will read for you. You just give me a 1 minute.
If anybody has any questions, you can unmute your mic and audio, and you can have a direct question answer sessions with Professor Savant. I'm really happy to announce that Professor Samant also has mentioned that he would be sharing his PPT to everyone.
Yeah. I will share.
Yeah, because this is a very important knowledge, and probably in this short time, it's a little difficult to gather such kind of information. So having a reference in the coming days would be really nice, Professor Samant.
Yeah. And Parag sir asks, what is he asks about the metadata. So metadata is the basically you can observe when we are doing the data mining. So meta, or we can say, which gives the basic information of the data, okay, and which can make finding and working with a particular data very easier manner. That is called metadata. Okay, so that we can define metadata basically here. If any other questions, then we can wait, and with your permission, ma'am, and Sharad sir, I don't know Sharad sir is there or not, but if you, we can conclude the session. I also appreciate if you give me the feedback from your end, okay, how was the presentation, because Sharad sir gave me some of the highlights, sir, unhe aisa chahiye, or really he was very, I was very taught about him, ki bahut input hai wo. कि सर हमें ये डिफरेंट एस्पेक्ट पे बात कीजिए, और मैंने उसी एस्पेक्ट पे थोड़ा 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 डालने की कोशिश करके कंप्लीट वर्ल्ड, बिकॉज ये हर एक टॉपिक बहुत बड़े बड़े वास्ट टॉपिक है, हर एक टॉपिक एक रिसर्च एरिया है, बट स्टिल आई डिड माय लेवल बेस्ट. I appreciate if you provide me the data. Yeah.
Surely, Professor Dattatreya Samant, we will give you a feedback about the participants' input. And would like to thank Pranita, because probably he has spoken from the artist's perspective of what knowledge needs to be shared with the employees. Because when we floated this program, we did get a feedback that how come we can implement this in artists, because presently not that kind of processes has been thought about in terms of digital skilling. So I'm sure with this overview webinar, we have got a certain idea about the technicalities or where is that we would like to proceed. So with this input and your presentation, we would like to thank you for providing us this facilitation, and along with that, we would also like to thank HK Kadam sir. It's very nice to have your guidance after your tenure with RCF and being associated with RCF to ensure that we get the best of the knowledge, and being you being the training head, it's of immense help to us, sir, and we look forward for this association, Kadam sir, and your guidance to our HRD team in the future as well. And thank you, Professor Savant, for giving us this very important information, and I'm sure participants will get back to us to have a little more in-depth kind of a knowledge in this area. So thank you very much, and we will provide the PPT of today's seminar to the participants. Thank you so much.
Here just I would like to highlight before leaving, we have developed also real time case study. We have implemented some of the IoT application as well at our academic level. Okay. Mm-hmm. And surely if Sharad sir, not this in COVID, but after some COVID, we will develop some of the collaborative work also with RCF and at our level. So we are like, so this is also one of the thing which I would like to discuss anytime. You can approach anyone on my email ID or contact number. But yes, lots of huge research area is there available, and lots of government funding is also available. If any fresh engineers or the diploma holders, they want to pursue their research in these areas.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much for sharing this important piece of information. And with this, thank you to all the participants, and we close today's webinar and look forward for your participation in the coming webinars, which will be organized by CMDC. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you, everyone. Stay safe, take care. Bye-bye. Good day.